Esteemed colleagues, dear Professor Güntürkin, dear fellows and students of the Max Planck Schools, in particular, dear new students starting this fall, a warm welcome on behalf of the German Rectors Conference. Today's event, the second Max Planck School Day, has at least three purposes. It's about welcoming new students. We want to organize the reunion of the first cohort, and we also want to create a kind of team spirit, which, as we all know, is inevitable for both teaching and learning and research. Circumstances, as our moderator has already mentioned it, have changed dramatically since last year. A new format has been developed, the first virtual Max Planck School Day, and I would predict that it would possible at least come back to our regular meeting conventions next year. So this is my optimistic perspective. There's more piloting in the pilot phase of the Max Planck School than anyone could have imagined in 2017. That's definitely the case. Today's program has at least three aspects, a threefold agenda. First, we will have a panel discussion providing the opportunity to learn more about some of the universities involved in Max Planck schools devoted to the topic of globalization. Then we have a personal keynote on the topic passion for science delivered by Professor Güntürkin, and I think passion is very important as a driving force for all kind of research we are doing. And last but not least, we will have a networking session for our MPS students. Globalization, the topic for our discussion. I think Max Planck schools are following a strong approach in order to become international and to attract international students. Actually, among the new students, there are more than 10 different nationalities. To give you a couple of figures, 17 students have been newly admitted to the Max Planck School of Cognition, 20 to the MPS of Matter to Life, and 21 to the MPS of Photonics. However, conditions for organizing internationalization have been limited, have been restricted during the last months. We are facing a lot of confinements, a lot of problems we have to cope with. The crisis has, last but not least, shed light on our global interdependency and vulnerability, the academic system, and the same counts for society at large, also for the global markets and global health system, is vulnerable. Our academic system, focusing that much on international relations, has to find alternatives, has to find new solutions to bring people together, at least virtually. We try our best, and one of the things we have learned in the past is that we can much better organize virtual meetings, virtual conferences that we were aware of before the crisis. When we're talking about internationalization or globalization, I think we have to take into account that the word globalization has two aspects for the science system. On the one hand, I think we are living under the conditions of competition, of global competition. On the other hand, we have a culture of collaboration, which is also an element of the global academic market and the global networks in which we are acting. This is kind of an opposition, I think. On the one hand, institutions are aiming at attracting the best people all over the world, the highly gifted talents. They want to improve their impact, their outreach activities. They want to increase in terms of reputation, in terms of results, in terms of applications. This is the institutional goal, the aim they are pursuing. On the other hand, there are the individual players, the researchers. They are not that interested in competition. They are interested in best working conditions, in good infrastructure. They are aiming at organizing their work in groups, and they are interested in exchange and intellectual inspiration. And they know that they can find this in networks, in collaborative networks. So to a certain extent, there is a tension between the elements of the academic system, the science system, on the one hand competition, on the other hand element of collaboration. But I think, and this could be one topic for our panel discussion, which I'm very much looking forward to, this could be overcome by some aspects. If you take into account that competition and collaboration are not a single opposition, but they are much closer than one might think at first glance, you would see that you can handle this a little bit better. So on the one hand, a part of our system, of our international system, is that it's going for brain circulation. That means that we want to attract people, that we are interested, that they contribute to the progress of our institutions, to the progress of research, and that they will leave the respective institutions after a couple of years and a certain period of time. So brain circulation means that also individuals are permanently overcoming hurdles, that they are in a permanent move and a permanent shift in a dynamic interaction with their colleagues. So brain circulation, I think, shows that our system of research and science is a very fluid one. And the second element, which shows that there is not a strict difference between competition and collaboration, is the aspect of brain sharing. We do not own the brains in our system. We want them to contribute, we want them to be a part of it, but we all know that they will leave us later. And we all know that diversity is enriching our system. So brain sharing means also that there is not only a national perspective, a national interest, which might be sometimes in the focus, but there is, beyond all that, also a transnational aspect in our research communities, which is very important. So, as you all see, it's necessary to have the system as an international system running and to invest into the system. How can we do this? I think first element, which is also underlined by the crisis, is that we need continued investment. Here in Germany, we're very happy about the fact that our academic system, our research system, is funded by public investment, by the government. We are not depending on tuition fees. The universities must not permanently increase their fees, and this has consequences for many students, as we know. And I think we have examples, bad examples, from many academic systems worldwide, which show that the increasing fees are a problem for the students. So we are grateful that in Germany our public state is still providing support for the universities on a very high level. So that enables us also to open the doors wide and to invite students from all over the world to come to Germany and to learn from the academic institutions. A second element, which is important, we have to find alternatives for physical mobility. Digitalization is helpful. In the end, I think we need blended measures. Graduate schools, Max Planck graduate schools, have already tested online learning formats long before Corona crisis. They are combining online and offline elements, and I think this will be the setting of the future, and we made good experiences with these patterns. And last but not least, I think we as representatives of the research system must take care that internationalization can also be organized under the conditions of Corona crisis. We must support incoming students and researchers who are struggling with administrative requirements and with travel restrictions due to the COVID-19 crisis. It's very important to overcome hurdles here and to be supportive and to show that our system is open enough. Also, there is a crisis, and although there are certain restrictions which are, to a certain extent, unavoidable. Here in Europe, we have tried our best also to continuously support internationalization by building networks. I would like to mention one single example. According to the initiative of French President Macron, who delivered a speech at the Sorbonne in the fall of 2017, reflecting the idea of a new system of European universities, we have this consortium of more than 40 European university alliances which are funded now. More than 30 German universities are participating in this network, and they are boosting the idea of a joint Europe and advancing the European education area and bringing that idea forward. So to conclude, post-COVID crisis will need more and not less international academic cooperation. That's an element which we should be aware of. We should make use of a good mixture between traditional and digital tools and formats. I think we have learned a lot of lessons in the last months, and we have shown that the research system is flexible enough to cope with these enormous challenges. I'm very much looking forward to an interesting debate with more insights on the specific approaches of German universities and the role of Max Planck schools in these crisis constellations, actually. I'm very much looking forward to an inspiring keynote, and most importantly, I wish all students and fellows of the Max Planck schools a successful start into this new, very unusual academic year. Thank you for your attention.